Sharks and rays are a really unique group of fish in that their skeleton is actually made of cartilage as opposed to bone, like bony fish. So this makes them much more flexible, dynamic in the water, and improves their hydrodynamics and means they can be light and agile. Sharks and rays actually have lots and lots and rows of teeth like scales known as denticles. And these denticles are actually really important for sharks and rays as they improve their hydrodynamics in the water, meaning that the water can flow really easily off their scales and it reduces the drag. So again, this improves their ability to be stealth predators, move through the ocean quickly and not have that heavy drag. Sharks and rays have a really unique way to manage their buoyancy underwater. Traditionally, bony fish have what we know as a swim bladder, which can be filled with gas to help them move up and down in the water column, whereas sharks and rays actually have a fatty liver instead. So you may have noticed that if you have a glass of water and put oil in it, the oil is more buoyant and floats on top of the water because it's less dense. And that's how a shark liver works. It's filled with this highly fatty oil and therefore it can float in the water column. The big difference between fish and sharks and rays is also in their gill systems. Fish traditionally have one gill with a plate covering known as an operculum, which can move to ventilate the gill, whereas sharks and rays actually have a modified system where they have 5 to 7 exposed gill slits instead. So this is really good for shark species that are highly mobile, need a lot of speed, and need to be able to oxygenate their muscles very quickly. Other species such as rays, which typically live more on the seafloor in the benthic environment, have a modified gill system. So they still have the 5 to 7 slits underneath their body, but they also have an opening behind their eye, which is known as a spiracle. And this means that when they're feeding and foraging in the sand and their gills might be covered, they can still ventilate and extract oxygen through the water. The main difference between sharks and rays is this gill configuration. So if you're ever wondering if you've seen a shark or a ray, rays have their gills underneath them, sharks have their gills behind their head. Possibly one of the most interesting things about sharks and rays is their sensory system. They can detect electrical currents and fields underwater, which is known as electroreception. And how they do this is with lots of little pores all over their body, much like the pores on our face, and they are filled with the jelly mucus matrix, which has compacted sensory cells, which are known as ampullae of Lorenzini. So basically, by having ampullae of Lorenzini, this means that sharks and rays can detect prey from far away. They can sense the vibrations. And this is a really amazing tool to have when you're a predator in the ocean. The other sense that sharks and rays can have, some species can detect the Earth's magnetic fields. So having this magnetoreception might actually assist them with migration and movement and being able to align themselves geographically and know where they are in the ocean. Sharks and rays are really important in our oceans as they are known as apex predators, which means they're at the top of the food chain. This means that they regulate all the other species through predation below them and they keep the system in balance. And without this, we would have single species dominating the environment, and this can actually decrease the biodiversity, which is something we know we need to have healthy oceans.